Every day, we interact with many products that were designed by engineers. But how did all these things go from a first idea to a final product? Well, a lot of the stuff in between is prototyping. Prototyping is a process by which we use material and time very efficiently in order to answer key questions about the things that we're trying to design. How can we make this mouse so that it's comfortable to hold? How can we make this bike so that it doesn't break when you ride it? These are the kind of questions you can answer with prototyping. Let's say you wanted to build a ball launcher, like something a volleyball player could use to practice without any teammates. What would you build and what questions could it answer? I want to know where to put the important parts in my design, and if it will be safe, and if it will launch a ball high enough. To answer some of these questions, let's make our first prototype. All right, let's make our first prototype out of cardboard. Now, cardboard's great because it's inexpensive, you can find it around the house, it's easily workable, and it's still pretty stiff, which makes it great for prototyping. Now, the first thing that we're gonna do is bend the cardboard, and for that, we're gonna use a straight edge. You use the straight edge to make a dent in the cardboard, but if it's too hard to make a dent, it helps to have a rubber mallet handy. So with just a whack, you've got a nice clean bend. Now the next thing that we're gonna go over is cutting cardboard with a utility knife. Now you have to be careful. These knives are incredibly sharp and that makes them one of the most dangerous tools in the shop. If you're not comfortable using one, then ask someone to give you a hand. One tip is to keep the blade retracted until you're going to use it. That way, nobody accidentally picks it up with the blade out and gets hurt. Now, one safe way to make a cut is to pretend that your fingers have already been cut off. That way, they're not going to stick out and get in the way of the cut. Then, you just take your blade, you place it up against the straight edge, and with a low cutting angle, like this, not like this, you make a few gentle passes. Now you want to use gentle passes so that way if you slip, you don't do any major damage. Go ahead and put the blade away and we've got a nice clean cut. The last thing that we're going to do is we're going to join pieces of cardboard together. And one tool that's great for doing that is a hot glue gun. Hot glue dries pretty quickly and that makes it pretty nice for putting prototypes together. It's also great for joining cardboard. It's really gonna stick it together well. So you kinda just wanna get one solid bead down, press the sheets of cardboard together, and wait for about 10 to 15 seconds. And then you've got a nice strong joint. So now, let's take these techniques and put them together to make a prototype. All right, so here's a model that I made to test out a volleyball launching concept, using just the techniques that we just went over for working with cardboard. You'll see it's just one big cardboard sheet with a few folds. And I used a special technique down here to make a curve. I actually made a lot of cuts underneath the cardboard that didn't go all the way through. And that kind of let me bend the cardboard into this ramp. And then I've got this hammer here that's attached with another cardboard piece. And that's going to act as a swinging weight that's going to hit the volleyball and launch it up into the air. So there are some other materials that you can use to make prototypes as well. One example is foam core, which is lightweight and still reasonably stiff and works in a lot of the ways that cardboard does. Foam core is two sheets of paper with foam in the middle and it's usually used as a backing for posters. But there's a lot of ways that you can use it to make prototypes. Another example is blue foam, which is usually considered sketching in 3D because blue foam is really easy to work with and sands really well. Another option, if you're looking for something a little bit stiffer, is wood. Wood is still pretty lightweight and it's pretty durable, and it sands really well, which makes it nice for making prototypes. I decided to make a prototype for a ball launcher out of wood in order to explore one concept a little further. So let's take a look at that. So here's our more refined prototype. This prototype is put together with wood and aluminum, so it's a little bit more sturdy, and it's going to be able to tell us a little bit more about our idea. This thing was put together with power tools, things like saws and drills. Now those techniques aren't featured in this video because you should really be safety trained before you try to operate those tools. In a workshop space like this that's dedicated to making prototypes, you can also see a lot of other really cool tools that help you make prototypes really quickly. We have a laser cutter which uses a powerful beam of light to cut sheets of materials like wood and plastic in really precise shapes. We also have a 3D printer that builds material up layer by layer to create really complicated geometries. Now that you know more about making prototypes, I hope you're excited to get out there and start building some stuff.